Cameras are ready. Everyone rolling. Stand by. 3, 2, 1, action!
Just so cool, man.
What a performance.
So we can look forward to some explosive moves.
I'm just looking at the synchronicity. Yeah, I'm thinking there's no way we're going to be able to do this.
Well, I think he is talented. He knows how to put a production together. He's really, really talented.
It seems that way.
But guys, we're also going to spend some time in the kitchen. I know earlier this week I got to share my baker's assorted biscuits family recipe. I made the peppermint crisp tart.
I bought 3 slabs of peppermint crisp.
So I hope you're going to try it out. But Graham, you're sharing your recipe with us today.
It's one of those, I suppose we could call it a stocking filler when it comes to recipes. The one thing that I loved the most was my mom makes an unbelievable roast chicken, but she always used to make the most incredible stuffing, kind of a sage being the dominant flavor in that. But I loved it so much that she would have to make like 3 or 4 extra just bowls of the stuffing. So we're going to throw together the perfect, most delicious, salty, gorgeous stuffing that you're going to have to make like 4 or 5 extra containers I would keep it. Then you can even have it on, as they do in in England, they'll put it on a sandwich, just put it everywhere. But it really is amazing. I think I love the fact that we've been able to get nostalgic with our Christmas recipes and go back, because this reminds me so much of a particular time of my childhood where I know Christmas Day was happening because I could smell that sage and the thyme coming out of the kitchen. And it's just, oh man, it's been such a cool time.
I'm looking forward to that because I never really grew up with stuffings and things.
It's quite English.
But I've made a variety of things in the kitchen, but you've got one up on me, dude. I've never made a stuffing, so I'm looking forward to jumping into it.
It's live, we've recorded it.
It's ridiculous,
I've beaten you in the kitchen.
I've never made a stuffing, so I'm looking forward to that.
Guys, I have to say, can you get down there? I was so inspired.
Christmas socks. Did you like that?
The team, man, I was so inspired by you this year and how immaculately styled you've been.
I love it.
You
paid so much attention.
I'm so predictable with my socks.
Well, the detailed socks have come out to play
today. And Patrice is not wearing any socks today.
So everyone's wearing socks to compensate for the fact that I'm not wearing any socks. They've gone all the way out to like the top of the sock game.
Listen, yeah, guys. Anyway, so get back. Well, it's festive. So we also have a Braai Christmas menu that we're going to be put together by gents named Car and Greg. Now, they are experts when it comes to Braai, putting together Braai menus and beer. So that is exactly, that's what they specialize in.
South African, that seem a little too enthusiastic. We're gonna get that. I was like, yes!
Man, listen guys, that's going to be amazing. We also have a clover custard Christmas cake bread and butter pudding. That's a mouthful. It's going to be absolutely delicious. Zoe, you like your sweet treats, eh?
I am, and you know what? I've been enjoying it in the kitchen lately, and I've been getting compliments for my cooking skills improving, so yes.
But the big question is, are you cooking at home? Are you going to cook
something? No, I'm not
cooking
at home, but I'm cooking here.
You're so blatantly honest. You're supposed to lie and say, yes, I cook for everyone at home.
I order my food off an app.
Zoe, how dare you order food off an app?
It's Christmas.
No, my mother will sort out Christmas.
Just one thing, please.
I'll make my peppermint Christmas.
Do that. Listen, guys, it's a Friday. We're feeling good. I hope you guys are feeling good. Quickly helping you out with what to wear going into your Friday. Taking a quick look at your weather. Johannesburg, 17 minimum, 33 is your maximum. Nice and hot. A hot afternoon going in there. So I'm thinking shorts and pluckies, man. That kind of vibe.
Vests. You guys get those vests.
Yes. Speedo, baby. Listen, don't lie. There was actually actually, I didn't even see this, but yesterday after we had a bit of a go at each other with the Speedo, there was a poll that went up
and
on Twitter.
Yes.
Yes, obviously.
And people want to see you guys in Speedos.
Oh boy, you're joining
yes.
Us. You are joining
us. You're going to have to wear one.
I wasn't there yesterday. It said, do you want to see Graham, Kat, and Ewan in Speedos? And I voted yes.
Listen, let's not go on, but the poll's out. We're going to see if we're going to make that happen. Okay, there's a whole week left to do that. Guys, in Durban, you can expect a minimum of 20, maximum 26. Also nice and easygoing weather. Warm conditions, morning changes towards the afternoon. No wind expected for today, so it looks like it's going to be a beautiful day. Port Elizabeth, 16, 23, partly cloudy conditions as well. Also nice and mild temperatures. You can expect a little bit of a southeasterly breeze of around 22 kilometers per hour. It is the windy city after all. There's always a bit of a breeze blowing. And down in Cape Town, 15 minimum, your maximum 22 degrees. Humidity is around 50%, peaks towards the evening, and a nice little cool breeze as well that will pick up. So I think we are dressed well in our kind of, what are we, resort luxe wear?
Yeah, man, I feel like I can kind of transition from daytime heat to nighttime cocktail party vibe, sunset sets, maybe a bit of a euphonic vibe in his residency.
You are setting the scene,
you can see,
my brother.
You can see it's my last day today. The
Well, by the way, we'll bring you a full weather report in just a little bit. But you're off on holiday now, man.
Oh, buddy.
You're going home to the Geordies.
Yeah, man. We go north, far north. So I leave on Sunday for the UK. I've got the last of my Premier League football shows tomorrow, and then we offered the family, taking little man to go and see the Geordie side of his family. So it's going to be intense. 14-hour flight with little,
going into winter.
Little
please
monkey,
don't pick
it's...
up an accent.
No,
Bubba has already picked up an accent. You asked Jack, what are you looking at? Not much.
Not much.
That was just after 2 weeks with the parents. But so very excited. But so excited that we've got such a jam-packed show. The international stars have been up to it. I don't know if anyone's got the latest on Kevin Hart, but I've seen his name popping up in social media. What's going
on? Kevin. So basically, if you don't know the story, he was selected to kind of host the Oscars, which is a huge deal. It's massive. Yeah. I mean, you have to live up to the A-list kind of, you know, kind of standard and what they expect from a host. And he was excited. He's like, it's a dream come true and I love it. And then 2 days after, news broke that the Oscars are looking for a new host because of old tweets surfaced from 2011 that Kevin Hart put out there, and it came to bite him in the backside, basically.
What's what you put out on social
media? Homophobic tweets were just so problematic.
They were very problematic.
Tweets I've kind of caught up with.
Sorry, buddy.
And the thing is, I mean, we love Kevin Hart, and he's cleaned up his act since 2011. No homophobic tweets, nothing has gone out on any of his platforms since then. But I mean, still, it's
if you've got a platform that's big and you know that many people are following
suicide.
So I don't know if they've selected someone new. Do we know if they've got someone new?
I don't think they've announced.
They've been looking
it
at old favorites like Ellen DeGeneres as well.
Shame, man.
Who, by the way, is talking about not continuing her show.
Ellen. It's the police.
Oh, it's the Grinch.
It's the boss man.
We're ready, man.
Look at my socks, Lucian. Look at my socks. Cool. And 5, 4,
here we go.
One. It's running.
Let's do it.